The Army is in transition. As we near the end of our involvement in Iraq and Afghanistan, we must prepare for whatever we might face in the future. The Army is the force that can rapidly adapt to exactly what the American people need in each new conflict and crisis. The force that can respond with decisive land power for any mission across a full range of military operations. But we haven't always been as successful as we planned to be. The Battle of Kasserine Pass in World War II and the ordeal of Task Force Smith in Korea are some well-known examples. By 1973, it was clear that Army training needed to change. So the Army created the United States Army Training and Doctrine Command, or TRADOC. From the beginning, we set forth the doctrine that the Army must be in a position to win the first and successive battles of the next war. General William Depew became TRADOC's first commander, and General Paul Gorman became TRADOC's deputy chief of staff for training. Throughout his distinguished career, General Gorman was and still is a training pioneer, and he was a key figure in many of the Army's training reforms. In his role at TRADOC, General Gorman knew that traditional methods of training were no longer relevant or effective.
The mantra of trainers back in those days was explanation, demonstration, practical exercise, which meant that the learners were largely passive during much of the training process.
Our focus changed from training predicated on the number of hours of instruction per subject to training executed through performance while conducting combat-relevant missions. This led to the concept of tactical engagement simulation, using simulated direct and indirect fires, mock casualties, and pitting units against a live thinking adversary bent on preventing them from accomplishing their missions. It turned rote exercise into simulating lessons on how to use terrain, fire, and movement to gain advantage over a dynamic opponent. We followed all training missions with honest and open after-action reviews that recognized both failures and successes during the exercises. Since that time, we have been continuously innovative in the use of new technologies for training. This enabled us to establish large training centers at Fort Irwin, California, Fort Polk, Louisiana, and in Europe. Training management is the primary leadership challenge. We believe that training must be the top priority for commanders. Army training today is blended training that uses live, virtual, and constructive simulation and multiplayer online gaming to achieve an operationally realistic training environment. We've developed the Training Brain Operations Center, which uses a comprehensive database gathered from real-world places and events, and overlays the data onto the training boxes at our combat training centers and our home station training areas. It puts soldiers inside authentically complex environments. The training brain will forever change the way the Army trains and fights. New cost-effective training technologies are appearing every day. Applications developed for smartphones or tablet computers will help soldiers track their training progress and provide job-specific aid. These applications will enable learning at the point of need, self-structured learning, and facilitate career-long learning. Prior to 2003, the Army focused primarily on major combat operations. Since then, we've centered our attention more on counterinsurgency. What will the future bring? Despite many signs and indicators of threats, only one thing is certain. We simply do not know who we will have to confront next. And preparing for such future uncertainty is our biggest challenge.
We don't know where the war will occur. We certainly don't know when it's going to occur. So we need to have a leadership cadre that is prepared to deal with whatever fate may assign them to.
It's clear that we must avoid being narrowly focused on one type of warfare. Each conflict is unique. Our Army doctrine must emphasize full integration with our joint, interagency, and multinational partners, and it must build adaptability into our units, training our soldiers and leaders to transition rapidly to meet any contingency. This is part of TRADOC's vision, leading the Army's transition into the future through developing adaptive leaders, innovative force design, agile modernization, and revolutionizing training to strengthen the Army by training the Army of 2020 today.